Hello world, welcome to quick tip number 25, view and review. In this sample, I'll show you a flight I had planned last year where I crashed my Mavic Pro. I'm gonna show you how that looks in real time. I mean the flight details. So here is our original plan. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna generate the flight and we're gonna save it and export it to Google Earth. That's it. Now we go to here we have the actual flight. You can see it's the Mavic Pro 4, batteries, this is the operating system, DroneLink, and we did fly 1 kilometer altogether. What I did is I took away from here, flew the mission, started, and I crashed here. So now of course we want to see how that looked and why. So we will download the KML and that's basically it. I have downloaded a KML file with all the Belgium airports which are required in the 2021 new EASA update, so that is very convenient. Starting points. Okay, now we're gonna import the two files. So we go to open. Here I have the two files. And here you can see the files. So let's go zoom in a little bit. The only thing is here, this is actually a 2D image, which I can't help, but I will give you an example how it looks in 3D. So here you can see the flight path and you can see it is actually a very straight flight, which is strange because there's quite a steep hill on the back and that's also the place where I crashed. So we go. So this is the original flight plan as you've seen before. So if we turn, okay, so this is where actually I should be. First start point was here. If I did that, then would nothing be happened because this is also on that hill. This is the hill. So I took off from here, flew, and this is the same flight as we've seen before. So if I add the other one, you can see actually the flight is, actually I started from here. Here's a small parking place. So meeting point, this all went well. And if we see this one, then you see this is the point where I crashed. Due to this map, as I showed in the previous video, I was also able to locate my drone. It's not completely correct, but okay, you cannot see the trees on here. But there was a big tree here, just away of this small tower, and that was where my drone is. So this is actually an easy way to, you see, to check your flight, and especially, which I will show another sample, this is how you can add your flight. Here we can view our flight and here we can review our flight. So it's good to compare, especially if you have a trail and you want to make sure you did everything correct. So both of those things you can load up to Google Earth and that works fine. As you can see, it's just a zip flight. I use this for a special reason because there is an update in the death version and I want to test that with my camera, which you can only do by the Inspire 1 or 2. Or of course with the M series. This is the restriction zone of the neighbors, which is also an update, and this all works fine. So I'm very happy and now let's see the result. This is a good sample of the advantages of the system where you can review your flight. This is a flight I did about half an hour ago with the dev version of DroneLink, where I want to test something with my Inspire 2, mainly rotating the camera while your drone is flying in a straight zip line. Okay, so this is the line, this is all good. So as you can see, the plan was 50 meters, going to a point, marker, go back to 25 meters, go back up to to the end of the frame here, go back to 30 meters and fly home in the destination. So that is the dip you see. Now, that all works very fine. So we're happy. Here you can see the flight I did with the Inspire. I have to tell you, there was actually a lot of wind because I want to do another mission with my Mavic and I had to stop that because of the wind. But as you can see, the Mavic of the Inspire actually, despite all the wind, flies very good. So that works good. And now, of course, the big trick. This is the same flight with the Mavic. So you can see the Mavic had a lot more work than the Inspire. You see, it is much more blowing off wind. I have to say the wind was from the west, so basically flying against the wind was a problem. With the wind, of course, no problem, but you can see it was blowing away here, fighting back. That all looked good. Now you can see really the difference between the two flights. Even when I take the zipline off, you see that the Inspire is much more straight line. I think that is one of the big problems you have with, for example, the Mavic Mini 1 and the Mini 2, is that, you know, they're just blowing away. They're just too small. They don't have enough body. They don't have enough weight. Especially they don't have enough power. My Mavic Pro was really struggling here. Well, you can see that the Inspire basically has no problem at all. Okay, this is the 3D sample I want to show you. It all works fine. I'm really happy and I hope somebody can use it and use it for the better. Okay, I'll see you at my next video.